Right, so we're going to have a look at quadratic functions and sort of everything we've learned about them. So the first thing is that this is a quadratic function. How do we know that? We know that because the x is squared. So that implies that this function is quadratic. We have to plot this in the domain. So remember, domain are your inputs or your set of x values. And the set of x values is here. It starts at -7 and it goes up to 1. So our inputs are -7, -6, -5, -4, -3, -2, -1, 0, and 1. You can input them into your rule, and the rule is 3x squared plus 19x plus 6, and then you end up with your output. So the first one I'll do, I'm not going to do all of them out because we can just use our calculators. So it's 3, and in place of the x, we're going to put in the input, which is -7 squared plus 19, and then -7, and then plus 6. So you can put this into your calculator using the table function, where you type in your 3x squared, your 19x, your plus 6, you get a start value of -7, because that's where we're starting. Our end value is 1, and we work in steps of 1. So for the answer to that, for the answer to -6, it's 0. For the answer to -5, it's -14. The answer to -4, getting -22. The answer to -3, I'm getting -24. -2, I'm getting -20. -1 is -10. 0 is giving me an answer of 6, and 1 is giving me an answer of 28. So you can see the ordered pairs. You have -7 and 20, so we're going to have to plot them together. So -7 and 20, then we have -6 and 0, -5 and -14. -4 with -22, -3 and -24, -2 and -20, -1 with -10, 0 with 6, and 1 with 28. So the y-axis is huge there. We have to go from -24 all the way up to plus 28. So it's quite an extensive y-axis, but we can have a look at that. Okay, so we're going to look now at the link between functions and patterns by looking at the differences. So if we look at the difference here, going from 20 to 0 is -20. The difference here from 0 to -14 is -14. From -14 to -22, that's -8. From -22 to -24 is -2. -24 to -20 is +4. From -20 to -10 is +10. -10 to 6, that's +16. And from 6 to 28 is plus 22. So the first differences, they're not constant, which we would expect. So we look at the second differences. So from minus 20 to minus 14, that's plus 6. Minus 14 to minus 8 is plus 6. Minus 8 to minus 2 is plus 6. Minus 2 to 4 is 6. 4 up to 10, that's plus 6 again. 10 to 16 is plus 6. And 16 to 22 is plus 6. So we have a constant second difference, which once again proves that it's quadratic. Now, I have this plotted here. So if you notice over here at the side, 3x squared plus 19x plus 6 is our function. I'll give you an idea. So you plot each of the points. So the first one was minus 720. So if I zoom in a bit. So minus 7 is here. And then I need to go up. And there's 20. So that point there is minus 720. The next one then is minus 60. So here's minus 6 and it crosses at 0. So we start in the center, we go left minus 6 and then we go nowhere. So that's your second dot there. Third one then is minus 5 minus 14. So here's minus 5, and we'll just follow that line down. And there it is there, minus 5, minus 14. So if you plot all the points, there's the shape of the graph. So the shape of that graph is U-shaped, which makes it quadratic. Now, let's look at our algebra link now. So, the function is 3x squared plus 19x plus 6. So, from algebra, we should be able to solve this, and then we will end up being able to recreate the same graph, okay? So, to get the guide number, we multiply the first by the last. So the guide in this case is 18. Factors of 18 are 1 by 18, 2 by 9, and 3 by 6. We're trying to get plus 19x. So which of these pairs has a chance of giving me 19? It's this one. To get those two numbers to give me 19, I'm going to have a plus 1. And a plus 18, because 1 and 18 makes 19. So I write down my 3x squared and I keep my plus 6, and then I'm going to expand my 19x and split it up into plus 1x and plus 18x. Then you go into the box. So 3x squared plus 1x plus 18x plus 6. We look for what's common between this and this, and the only thing common is the x. So now, 3x squared is made up of x multiplied by what? And the answer there is 3x. So if you multiply 3x by x, you get 3x squared. The next one, 1x is made up of x and what? So that's 1. So 1 times x makes 1x. And then the last one is the 18. So the 18x is made up of 3x and what else? So 3x times what makes 18x? And that's 6. So we write down from across the top 3x plus 1, and from down the side x plus 6. We solve it, so you split the page, you take your 3x plus 1 and you let it equal 0, and you take your x plus 6 and you let it equal 0. We're going to solve for x, which means we need to bring that across. It'll become a minus, so that gives us 3x equals minus 1, and then we're going to divide by 3 to get rid of that 3, but if you do it on the left, you have to do it on the right. So we're getting x equals minus 1/3. And then on this side, you take the plus 6, you bring it across, and it becomes a minus 6, and then that's gone. So we get x equals minus 6. These are the roots of the equation. And the roots of the equation is where the graph should cross the x-axis. So we go to our graph now and check if it does indeed cross at minus 1 over 3 and minus 6. And then the other thing we should be able to check is that from a geometry point of view, the final term, the constant term, the one that doesn't have any x's on it, is also known as the y intercept. So it should be the case that this graph crosses the y-axis at 6. Okay, and that's a bit of geometry, y-intercept. So the graph should cut the y-axis at 6, and it should cut the x-axis twice. Once at minus 1 over 3 and once at minus 6. So we have a quick look at that. If I zoom in, so definitely cutting there at minus 6, and that was one of our roots here. And then if you look here, you zoom right in, okay, there. So you can see here that there's minus, this is minus a half. So this part here is minus 1/3 or minus 0.33. And that is where it's cutting the x-axis. So we checked it and it's definitely cutting the x-axis at minus 6 and minus 1/3. The last thing to check then, is it cutting the y-axis at 6? So we'll go up here to the y-axis, zoom out a bit. There it is there, crossing the y-axis at 6. So that works. Okay, so that is quadratic equations from a functions point of view, doing an input-output table, generating your graph from a sequences and series point of view, looking at your constant second difference. From an algebraic point of view, picking out your roots. And then from a geometry point of view, looking at your y-intercept.